Let's work through another related rates problem together. So here's the situation. A trough is 12 feet long and 4 feet across the top. Its ends are isosceles triangles with an altitude of 3 feet. Water is being pumped into the trough at 2 cubic feet per minute. How fast is the water level rising when it is 1 foot deep? Okay, so let's start by kind of setting up our picture. I sort of already have an outline here, but we want to establish our variables and fill in any additional information that's relevant. Okay, so what's happening in this problem? Well, I have this trough, and the dimensions of the trough itself are as shown. It's 12 feet long, 4 feet wide, and then 3 feet high. The height of the triangle sides are 3 feet high. And then we have water that's being pumped into this trough. And then ultimately we want to know how fast is the water level rising at a particular moment in time, specifically when the water is 1 foot deep. So let's think about what quantities we're given and what we're looking for and establish a variable on our picture here. So we're told water is being pumped into the trough at 2 cubic feet per minute. Okay, so what is that telling us? That's actually telling us about the volume. So water being pumped into the trough, that sort of volume that's being pumped into the trough. So this is volume here. And then how fast is the water level rising? That's asking us about the height of water in the trough. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and establish a variable on my picture. I'm going to call that height of the water H. So as more water is pumped into the trough, of course, that height is going to rise. Okay, so we have a good picture here. The next step we want to do is to write down the rates we know and the rates that we're looking for. So what do we know from the problem? What piece of information or which rate are we given? Well, the rate that we're given is that water is being pumped into the trough at 2 cubic feet per minute. And we said just a second ago that that's telling us about the volume of water in the trough. So I'm going to say then dV dt, so I'm going to let V represent the volume, so dV dt equals 2. Okay? What other rates are mentioned in this problem? Well, the only other rate that's mentioned is how fast the water level is rising, and that's the rate that we're actually looking for. So I called the height of the water H, so then that rate of change is going to be dH dt, and that's what I ultimately want to find. Okay, so we have the rate we know and the rate we want to find. Next, we want to find some sort of relationship between the variables in our story. So what are the variables in our story? Well, we've got the volume of the water in the trough and the height of the water in the trough, and those are the things we're interested in. So in this particular instance, it kind of seems like some sort of geometric formula is going to be what's useful to us in this situation. And in this case, actually, specifically, it's going to be the volume of the trough. So, in general, the volume of any three-dimensional shape like this is going to be the area of the face times the length of the shape. So, in this case, it's going to be the area of the triangle times the length of the trough. Okay? So the area of a triangle is always 1/2 base times height. Okay? And then the length of the trough in this case is 12. Okay? So then the volume becomes 6 times base times height. Okay, so let me kind of back up a step and make sure I clarify which volume we're talking about here. So I have my shape, the trough, right? Just don't even think about the water for a second, but just the trough as a physical object has a volume, right? And I could find that by using the dimensions I'm given here, the 12, the 4, and the 3, I could find the volume of the trough as a whole. But what I'm actually meaning when I say volume here is the volume of water in the trough. And that's not necessarily going to be the entire volume of the trough itself, right? So if I look in my picture here, I'm trying to find the volume of the water. Right, like this. I'm trying to find the volume of this shape here. So that's going to be 1/2 base times height, where the base and the height are the base and the height of this triangle here. So base and height. And then the 12 just comes from the length, and that's always going to be 12. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. If not, you might just want to replay that part and kind of think about that geometry. But the volume of the water at any point in time is 6 times base times height, where the base and height are of that triangular face of the water region. Okay, so we have a relationship. But remember that one important step in our related rates process is to eliminate variables from the equation for which we don't know the rate of change. Except for the one who we're actually looking for, of course, but we don't want extra variables in our equation that we don't have any rates for. So let's look at our equation here. What do we have? So we have V equals 6BH. Well, I know dV dt. Okay, so V is fine. I know dV dt. And dH dt is what I'm actually looking for, so that's fine. I want to keep the H. But what about this B, this base? I don't have any information about the rate of change of the base of this triangle. So I don't want that variable in my equation, so I need to think of a way to eliminate that variable somehow. And we're going to do that by a little bit of a geometry trick. So let's look a little bit closer here at what's happening in the trough. So here's the face of my trough. It's, we know, 4 feet wide, and then the height is 3 feet. But then what I actually have is I have water, you know, that's filling up this trough. So, you know, at some point in time, I might have this much water. And then at another point in time, I might have this much water. And, you know, then I keep filling it up. But at any point in time, if you can imagine the trough being sort of clear and you're looking into it, that water is going to look like a triangle. The way it fills up the trough is going to be triangular in shape when you're looking at the face of it. Okay, so the geometry trick I'm going to use here is actually the trick of similar triangles. Okay, so if we think about these two triangles here, so I have, once again, my whole trough, 4 feet wide, 3 feet high, and then I have the water level, and remember, we're representing the height of the water by the letter H. These triangles are similar, right? They share this angle, and their sides kind of go along together. So these are similar triangles. And so the ratio of the base and height of the triangles is always going to be constant. Okay, so let me write that in math and then maybe try to explain it one more time to you. Okay, so let me write this relationship. So if we think about just the face of the trough, the base of that is 4 units, and the height is 3. Okay, so that's where this 4 over 3 is coming from, the ratio of the base to the height. So I'm saying that that ratio for the water, for the shape of the water as it fills up the trough, is going to stay the same. So I'm saying that the ratio is always going to be 4/3, no matter how full that face is. Okay, so then 4/3 equals the base over the height. So now we have this relationship between the base and the height, and we can actually solve for B in this relationship, right? And I could say B equals 4/3 H. And this is a relationship between B and H that's always true. Okay, now all I have to do is take this relationship and plug it in to my volume formula, and I've eliminated the variable that was causing issues. So let's do that. So V equals 6 times B, but I just said B was 4/3 H times H. Okay, and then 4/3 times 6 is 8, so this becomes 8 H squared. Okay, so now I've got myself into a much better situation because I only have V and I only have H, V and H together, and those are the two variables I actually care about, that I actually have information about. So now I can proceed with the next step of the related rates procedure, which is to take the derivative with respect to time, remembering to use a chain rule. Okay, so I have V equals 8H squared. The derivative of V with respect to time is just dV dt. And here I've got 16H dH dt. Okay, now what I'm actually looking for, ultimately, if you remember, is dH dt. So I'm just going to solve this for dH dt. So if I do that, I get dH dt equals, I divide the 16H to the other side, so that's 1 over 16H dV dt. Okay, and now I know all the stuff on the right-hand side. So 1 over 16H, remember, I'm looking for the rate of change of dH dt at the particular instant when H is 1 foot deep. So when the water level is 1 foot deep is when H equals 1. Okay, so H is 1. And then I know dV dt, that's information I was given in the problem, so dV dt is 2. So this is 2 over 16, or 1/8. So the height is changing at a rate of 1 over 8, and that would be feet per minute, because the height is measured in feet and the time is measured in minutes. So the rate of change of height, 1 over 8 feet per minute. Okay, so just a quick recap of what we did, because I realize this, this is pretty confusing. This is pretty tricky stuff. So we started the way we always do with a related rates problem. We read the problem and we drew a picture. And in this case, what we had is we had this trough and it's filling up with water. Okay, and what we said was that H was the height of the water in the trough at any point of time. So that was our picture. Then we established our rates of change. So we were told that water was being pumped in at a rate of 2 cubic feet per minute. So that's dV dt. That's the rate of change of the volume of the water in the trough. Okay, so we know that. And then we said what we're actually looking for is dH dt, which is the rate of change of the water level, of the height of the water. So then we thought about the relationship that we could write between volume and height. And in this case, we used the volume of this trough shape, the volume of the water in the trough, which was the area of the triangular face times the length of the trough. So the area of the triangle is just 1/2 base times height, and the length of the trough is always 12. So I got 1/2 base times height times 12, which is 6 base times height. So now I'm here at this step. Okay. So we have volume equals 6 base times height. And we realized that we care about the volume and we care about the height, but we don't have any information about the base. So we need to somehow eliminate that variable. And the way we did that is by similar triangles. Okay, so the trough itself, if we just think about the trough, the face of it, the base is 4 and the height is 3. But as the water fills it up, it also makes a triangle shape. and the ratio of the base and height of that triangle of the water filling it up keeps this that same 4/3 ratio because they're similar triangles. So we wrote this relationship 4/3 equals base over height. So that's just similar triangle constant proportion relationship. And then that relationship we saw for B. And then we took that expression for B and plugged it into our volume formula, and that allowed us to eliminate B, which is what we wanted. So then we were able to get V equals 8H squared. And then from there, it was pretty standard. You know, we took the derivative with respect to time, and we solved for dH dt because that's what we're looking for. And then we plugged in H as 1 because we were looking for the particular instance when the height of the water is 1. And we plugged in dV dt, which we knew to be 2, and we got our answer. So when the height is 1 foot of water, then the height is changing at a rate of 1/8 feet per minute.